the features you have seen here show that the sparrow was created with all its attributes to fly. The peacock's most distinguishing feature is its highly decorated tail. The females have no such adornment. It is only possible to see the tail feathers of this bird, with its blue head and neck, in the mating season, when the male opens up its tail to attract the female and produces an astounding fan. The male peacock has some 200 tail feathers, which are replaced every year. Some 170 of these are in the shape of eyes and are known as eye feathers. The remaining 30 give the fan its exquisite outline and are known as T feathers. The eyes are distributed in a very regular manner over the fan. At the microscopic level, both T and I feathers possess very complex designs. Each one of the eyes is visible because there are short feathers in the front of the fan and long feathers behind. The tiny hairs on an eye feather are close together at the top and more widely spaced at the bottom. Thanks to this wide spacing at the bottom, the part containing the eye is brought out by the creation of a contrast. The colors in a peacock's feathers are principally attractive because they are bright and striking. These striking colors change according to the angle from which one looks at them. This happens not because of color pigments, but due to an optical effect known as the thin film, which takes place in feather barbules. It is, of course, impossible for the peacock to perform such detailed calculations and install such a design in its own body. It is also impossible for it to know that these magnificent designs will impress female peacocks. The creator who planned this extraordinarily beautiful tail in all its detail is Almighty God, Lord of the earth and sky, and all that lies between. Most living things in nature treat their own ailments. Animals such as the hippopotamus, water buffalo, elephant, and rhinoceros bathe in mud to get rid of parasites on their skin. No microbe or parasite can survive in mud. Clay mud, in particular, helps wounds to form a crust and heal. Elephants carefully rub pieces of clay soil with its antiseptic properties over their wounds, or throw dust over wounds with their trunks to seal them up. The noteworthy aspect of the methods animals use to treat themselves is that they all know very well what they are doing and determine what will work well for which illness. It is, of course, impossible for a rhinoceros or an elephant or any other living thing to know that mud has an antiseptic property. All the living things in nature behave in line with God's inspiration. Omniscient God is He who watches and protects His creations. Cold light. Scientists have still not discovered how this light comes into being. Fireflies, one of the creatures that produce light, do so with 100% efficiency. A normal light bulb, on the other hand, can only transfer 4% of electrical energy into light, the rest being given off as heat. Cold light is very bright. So much so that South American native peoples use the insects that emit cold light as torches to light their way by putting them in baskets. In producing light, the firefly combines a special chemical in its body known as luciferin with an enzyme called luciferase. This enzyme consists of nearly 1,000 amino acids. Despite our present-day advanced technology, scientists are still unable to reproduce this enzyme. Yet this tiny insect is capable of producing this enzyme while lacking any knowledge about it at all. So why does this creature produce such a light? What can the purpose of that light be? These insects use light as a means of communication. Insects landing on the leaves of a tree send a signal to another group further off by all emitting light at the same time. The reason why they do this is not yet fully understood. All the details in the production of cold light are proofs that these creatures are the work of a superior intellect and infinite knowledge. God has created all the living species on earth with their own different features. Thus revealing to us His infinite might. It is revealed in one verse of the Quran that people must think deeply on this truth. Among His signs is the creation of the heavens and earth and all the creatures He has spread about in them, and He has the power to gather them together whenever He wills. None of the living things we have been watching possesses any consciousness of intellect. Some even have no brain at all. Indeed, to ascribe the features these living things possess to them, to say, for example, that a dragonfly engages in superior acrobatics by using its own intellect, is incompatible with reason and logic. To claim that the complex systems possessed by these creatures, their perfect harmony with nature, came about as the result of chance, is no less irrational and illogical. Clear evidence can be seen, however, that there is a superior intellect and great knowledge in every one of these living things. The Lord of that intellect and creator of that perfect harmony displayed in nature is God, creator of everything in the universe. The flawless creation of Almighty God is revealed in another verse from the Quran. He is God, the creator, the maker, the giver of form. To him belong the most beautiful names. Everything in the heavens and earth glorifies him. He is the Almighty, the All-Wise.